reflection. Reflection. The elementary, the important property of the light is reflection. What is the definition of reflection? The light traveling in a homogeneous medium, if it faces an obstacle, it traverses back into the same medium, is called a reflection of the light. Now let us consider, this is the obstacle. This is X and Y is the obstacle. Now there is a homogeneous medium. This is the homogeneous medium. Now there is a light ray. This is the light ray. This is the light ray. Light ray faces an obstacle right here. Light is falling here. Right? It traverses back into the same medium. It traverses back into the same medium. It traverses back into the same medium. Is called reflection. Right? This is the obstacle. Right? This is the medium. As the light is traveling in a homogeneous medium, if it faces an obstacle, traverses back into the same medium, such a phenomena is called reflection of light. Now, here, this is called XY obstacle. The incoming ray, let us consider AO, is called incident ray. Now, the outgoing ray, OB, is called reflected ray for the obstacle. Now, there is a normal. Now, there is a normal. This is the normal. Now, the normal is represented by N. Now, the angle between incident ray to the normal is called I. Therefore, the I is called angle of incidence. Right? Next. The angle between normal to the reflected ray is called angle of reflection. Right? In the reflection process, right, the AO is called, what to say, AO is called incident ray. Incident ray. Right, OB is called reflected ray. Right, ON is called normal. ON is called normal. Now, incident ray intensity is I. Reflected ray intensity is I dash. Incident ray intensity is I. Reflected ray intensity is I dash. Incident ray, what to say? Wavelength lambda. Here is also reflected ray wavelength lambda. Incident ray frequency nu. That is reflected ray frequency also nu. Incident ray speed is c. Reflected ray speed also c. Now in this case, in the reflection process, light frequency, light wavelength, light speed, light has a certain phase, they will not change. What are the physical quantities to be changed? What are the physical quantities to be changed in the reflection? Right? Intensity is going to be changed. right? Next. Right, as the intensity is going to be changed and the direction of light ray is also changed. Direction of light ray. Therefore, as the light ray is traveling in the direction of AO, in the absence of X and Y, it might have been traveled like this. Therefore, because of this obstacle, instead of traveling, it will travel like this. Therefore, in the reflection process, intensity is going to be changed and the path of the light, the direction of the light is also going to be changed. Now, next one. What are the laws of reflection? Laws of reflection. What are the laws of reflection? Right? Now, in the laws of reflection, first one, angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. Second one, right? Incident ray, right? Normal and reflected ray lie in a same plane. Right now, here the reflection takes place according to certain rules. The rules followed by the light under the reflection are called the laws of reflection. What are the laws of reflection? Angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. Right? Incident ray, normal, reflected ray are lie in the same plane. Generally, this is called, what to say, scalar form. Scalar form of laws of reflection. Sometimes there is a vector form. Right? There is a vector form. What is the vector form? Now, let us consider, this is the incident ray. This incident ray, along the incident ray, the unit vector is E cap. Along the reflected ray, the unit vector is E2 cap. Right? Along the normal, the unit vector is N cap. Now, E2 cap is equals to, that is E1 cap minus 2 into, that is E1 cap dot N cap into N cap. This is the vector form of loss of reflection. Right? Now, incident angle is equals to reflection angle. Whatever we are saying, it is the scalar form. Right? Incident ray, normal, reflected ray are lie in a same plane. Right? The vector form of loss of reflection is, right, E2 cap is equals to E1 cap minus 2 into E1 cap dot N cap into N cap. What is E1 cap? The unit vector along the incident ray. What is E2 cap? The unit vector along the reflected ray. What is N cap? It is the unit vector along the normal. Next one. As they are lying in the same plane, that is, incident ray is represented by a vector I cap. Reflected ray, right, normal is represented by N cap.